Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today's story is most fascinating. Today we find King Pariksit's son Janamejya performed a snake sacrifice yagna in which hundreds and thousands of snakes were offered into the fire. Like they were thrown into fire as an offering, and how it almost ended the whole species of snakes, right? The rage the king had, Janamejya, was so immense that he went to a degree where he wanted to get rid of all the snakes from the earth, right? That much anger he had. Now, why did he have such an anger and what happened afterwards? Please hear the whole story, what happened, right? It's definitely worth listening. One of the best stories we are find. All right. So before I narrate the story, let me tell you a little bit about it. Alright, so Pariksit was born to Uttara and Abhimanyu. He was the grandson of Arjun and he was saved by Lord Krishna in the womb of his mother when Aswatthama directed weapon, it's a spiritual weapon, Brahmastra on him. Since the baby had been protected by Vishnu in his form of Krishna, the Brahmanas proposed that he should be named Vishnu Rata, that is, protected by the Vishnu. But the baby had met Krishna inside the Uttara's womb and had become devoted to Sri Krishna. Whenever the child met someone, he tested to see if the person he had just met was indeed the person whom he had met inside the womb. The word for a test is called Pariksha. That is the reason that Vishnu Vrata came to be known later on as Pariksit. Marriage and ascendancy to the throne. He married to Iravati, the daughter of Prince Uttar. Pariksit and Iravati had four sons, the most important of whom was Janamejya. Pariksit also performed three Ashwamedh Yajna horse sacrifice on the banks of River Ganga. Pariksit's guru teacher was Kripacharya. Pariksit became the successor of Pandavas when they decided to leave for the heavens. Now, this is the interesting part. Sage Samika in meditation and the unfortunate snake incident. Alright, so this is where everything begins, the whole story. This is the starting beginning of it. One day, while traveling through the forest, he became very exhausted and entered the hut of a sage named Samika. As he was thirsty, he found the sage in deep meditation. He paid his respects several times, but as there was no response, frustrated, he took a dead snake and threw it around the sage's neck. Right, so here King Pariksit, he was traveling through the forest, and when he saw this sage, he did not respond, so he got angry and he put a dead snake over his neck. Later, when the sage's son, Sringin, heard of this incident, he cursed the king to die of a snake bite on the seventh day. Right, so the sage's son saw the dead snake on his father's neck and he got angry and he cursed the Pariksit that he will die in 7 days by the bite of a snake. Right, following this incident, the king handed over throne to his son Janamejya. So king finds out that he got cursed by a sage son, so he knew that his death is stalking at him, he's gonna die in 7 days. So what king did, he handed over the throne to his son Janamejya and spent next 7 days listening to the discourses of sage Sukhdev, son of Vedvyas, and the book was compiled as Bhagavad Purana. Having heard the Bhagavad Purana, Pariksit worshipped Sukhdev. He told the sage that he was no longer frightened of being beaten to death by a snake. He had learned the nature of the soul, Atman, and the Brahman, the Supreme Spirit. When the Sukhdev left, Pariksit sat down and began to meditate. Takshak, this is the great serpent, Takshak. Takshak disguised himself as a Brahman in order to get near the king. Then, as per the curse that was laid down by the sage's son, a snake Takshak came into a form of Brahman. He sat down near the king as a Brahman and then he bit the king and Pariksit died, right? Now, this is when Pariksit's son Janamejaya gets angry. They say he was so furious that he resolved to perform a snake sacrifice, Sarpyagna, at which all the snakes would be killed. They would be consumed in the fire of Yagna. And they say that Taksak, at that time, he was so scared that he fled to the heaven of Indra and he asked for the protection, right? But Janamejaya urged his brahmanas to chant the most powerful mantras so that he could not be spared. So the serpent cannot be spared and he would be offered in fire and be killed, right? So now we're gonna find what happens when Janamejaya decided to do this thing, sacrifice of. Alright, so then the king in his anger again said unto the mantra knowing brahmanas that these words bent upon the destruction of Taksak, the great snake which killed my father. If the snake Taksak be in the abode of Indra, cast him into the fire with Indra himself. That much angry this Janamejaya is. Then Sauti, the narrator, continued saying, urged thus by the king Janamejaya about Taksak, this yagna poured in the yagna, they were poured libations, naming that snake, then staying there. And even as the burnt offerings were poured, Taksak became anxious and afflicted. Then he became visible in a moment in the skies. Then Purandra, seeing that sacrifice, became much alarmed and quickly casting the Taksak off, went back to his abode. After Indra had gone, Taksak, the prince of snakes, was in immense fear and by the virtue of the mantras brought near enough to the flames of the sacrificial fire. O king of the kings, the sacrifice of thine is so alarming that almost all these snakes got afraid. So now what happens is that there is one more person who actually visits the sacrifice, you know, and he is like a Brahman and he's asking for a boon to the Janamejaya. And Janamejaya said that thou immersible, one of the such handsome and childlike feature, I desire to grant thee a worthy boon. Therefore ask thou that which thou desire in thy heart. I promise that I'll grant it. Alright? Then the person who came in the sacrifice, that Brahman, he said, O monarch, behold, Taksak is soon coming under thy control. Great serpent, his terrible cries and loud roar is being heard. Assuredly, the snake had been forsaken by the wielder of the thunder. His body being disabled by your mantras, he is falling from the heaven. Even now, rolling in the skies and deprived of the consciousness, the prince of snakes cometh, breathing loudly. Sauti continued, while Taksak, the prince of the snake, was about to fall into the sacrificial fire, during those few moments, Astika spoke as follows. Astika is a Brahman. O Janamejaya, if thou would grant me a boon, let this sacrifice of thine come to an end, and let no more snakes fall into the fire. O Brahmana, the son of Pariksit, being thus addressed by Astika, became exceedingly sorry and replied unto Astika, thus, O illustrious one, gold, silver, whatever other possession thou desired, I shall give unto thee, but let not my sacrifice come to an end. Astika thereupon replied, gold, silver, or kind, I do not ask of thee, O monarch, but let thy sacrifice be end, so that my maternal relations be relieved. Sauti continued, the son of Pariksit, being thus addressed by Astika, repeatedly said this unto the foremost of speaker, O best of the Brahmanas, ask some other boon, O blessed be thou. He did not beg any other boon. Then all the sadhyas conversant with the Vedas told the king in one voice that let the Brahmana receive the boon. So this is where actually the Janamejaya finally decides to stop the sacrifice yagna. Sauti replied, many thousands and tens of thousands and billions of snakes fell into the fire. O most excellent Brahman, so great is the number that I am unable to count them all. I have not been able to name all, the number being countless. The sons of these snakes, the sons of those sons that were burnt, having fallen into the fire. I'm unable to mention, there are so many, some of them 3 heads, some of them 7, others of 10, and of poison like unto the fire at the end of the yuga, the terrible in their form, they were burnt by the thousands. Many other of huge bodies of great speed, tall as a mountain, summits of the length of a yama yojana, and of 2 yojana, capable of assuming the form at will of any size, and master at will any degree of strength or poison like unto blazing fire, afflicted by the curse of mother, and were burnt into the sacrifice by Janamejaya. Alright guys, so very fascinating story. What we find that when Pariksit Raja King was cursed that he's gonna die within the 7 days, and this Takshak, the great serpent, he's the one who comes and bites Pariksit King, and he dies in 7 days. After 7 days he dies, and this is when that Janamejaya, the son of Pariksit King, becomes angry and decides to take a revenge on Takshak. Not only he goes after the serpent Takshak, but he also goes after the whole species of snake. And as we saw that within the story, they say that tens of thousands and billions of the snakes were offered into the fire, right? Like, and it also goes to the far that some were so terrible and some were like had power. They could assume form at will, shape, strength, and had a great poison. And all of them, all those terrible snakes were offered into the fire, and most of them, they died, right? So this Janamejaya, he took a great revenge upon the snake and the prince of the snake, Takshak, serpent, right? And Takshak, they say that he fled away. He got spared because at the moment when he was about to be offered into the burnt, into the sacrifice yagna, at the time that one of the brahmanas, Ashtika, who came and requested, and because he forced him to ask for a boon, and at that point Janamejaya had to give him a boon, and he asked for the boon to stop the sacrifice, and he had to stop the yagna. Otherwise Takshak would be burned to ashes, because those brahmanas who were chanting the most powerful mantras, they were bringing Takshak from the highest heaven, and they were forcing losing consciousness of Takshak and getting burnt into the fire, but at the last moment it got stopped, right? So very fascinating story guys, and if you enjoy these kind of stories, if you enjoy the content, please feel free to subscribe. And again, thanks a lot for your time and have a great day. Thank you.